In this video, we're going to take a look at the Health app on the iPhone. We're going to take a look at some of its key features. This includes how you can view your different health categories, how you can add your own data, and how to make sure that the information that's most important to you is easy to find. I'll also show you how you can connect your healthcare providers and even how to securely share your health data with others. Now, before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the Health app on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Now, the first thing that we need to do is we need to open up the Health app. It's the icon with a little heart on it. So I tap on it to open it up. First thing I want to point out is across the bottom here, we have three different tabs. This is basically how we get around the app. So our first tab here, Summary. This is where we can personalize what we want to see. It can give us an at-a-glance look at key metrics such as steps, heart rate, or sleep. And it's based on what you want to put in there. Basically, what you do is you pin a category over into the summary here. We'll come back to this one. Then our next one here is Sharing. This is where you can view shared data. So if someone on another iPhone is sharing their data with you, their health data with you, this is where you can view that. This is also where you can set up if you want to share your data with someone else. And again, we'll come back to this one. Right now, we're going to focus on Browse. Think of this as your library. This is where we can view all of the different categories. First thing is this is divided into a few different categories. So you're going to see I have health categories here. Health categories include activity, body measurements, hearing, your heart, your medications, nutrition, respiratory, things like that. Now, where it gets its data from are from different devices. So this could be my Apple Watch. It could also be from a glucose monitor. It can be from the iPhone itself. So depending on what devices you have, you might have more or less data than what I have here. Now, my Apple Watch keeps track of my heart rate, so I'm going to have heart data in here. My Apple Watch keeps track of my mobility, so I'm going to have mobility information in here. But I do not keep track of any type of nutrition, so I'm not going to have any nutrition information in here. What you can do is you can download an app where you can count your calories, and then it'll add it over to this area here. So these are our different health categories. In addition to that, we also have health records. Now, this comes from your provider, such as your hospital or your doctor's office. So when I get any lab results, what I'm able to do is view my lab results. It gets it from my provider, such as my hospital. I want to view my medication records. I can view my medication records. So what we do is we connect this up to our health providers. And when we scroll up, you're going to see that I have mine connected to four different providers here. Corwell Health, Holland Hospital, Rite Aid, and then Trinity Health. So how do you go and add your provider? You just tap on Add Account, and when you do, you can search for your different providers here, and then you just log in, and then your information will transfer over to the Health app. Now, not all health providers will connect up to the Health app, so in some cases, you may not be able to connect up to the Health app. But what you can do is you can just search in here and see if your provider connects up. And it is secure. I'm going to cancel here. So that is the layout for the browse. Now let's take a look at a few of these categories and see what information we have. So what I'm going to do is swipe up here. Let's take a look at activity here. I tap on that. And then what we have is a number of different subcategories. So from here, I'm able to see my actual activity. I can also see my active energy, as well as my stand minutes. You can see that I have a number of different categories on here. And then if I want to dig down deeper, I can do that as well. So let's go with stand minutes here. I tap on it. And now what I'm able to do is view my stand minutes by day, week, month, 6 month, or year. So I'm able to see trends. Am I standing more? Am I standing less? And then below that, I can read more about what this category means, and then I can pin it to my summary. So when you pin it to the summary, what it's going to do is it's going to show up under the summary here. So let's just go ahead and tap on that. Maybe I'd like to keep track of that. So now I've just pinned it to my summary. To unpin it, we just tap on it again. You can see it says unpin. Now below that, I can also show all of the data and I can see where it's getting its data from. So let's go ahead and tap on this and see where it's getting this data from. In my case here, it's getting it from my Apple Watch. So if you're ever curious of where it's getting its data from, that's how you can do that. Let's take a look at another one. I'm going to go back and we're going to go and take a look at heart. I tap on it and now I can see my heart rate, my heart variability, as well as my resting heart rate. And when I tap on it here, again, I can see trends. I can swipe up. I can see highlights. So it's going to show me highlights of my heart. And then I can read more about it, as well as see different apps that will help me track my heart rate. And then I can also pin it to my summary. You can see that this is pinned. And if I want to see where the data is coming from, I can do that as well. And then below that, I can also set different notifications for it. So if I have a high heart rate, what I can do is I can enable that notification. Or if I have a low heart rate, I can enable that notification. So then it'll notify me when I have a high or low heart rate. Let's go back and take a look at one more. This time what we're going to do is we're going to take a look at body measurements. This is where I can view my weight. So I tap on it. We can see I have all of these different body measurements. And we have weight here. I tap on that and I can see again my weight by date so I can see any trends. I can see which apps will help me track my weight. And when I swipe up, I can also pin it to the summary. And I can view my data sources. So where is it getting this data from? Well, when I tap on this, you're going to see that I have a withing scale. So my withing scale talks to the health app. I step on the scale, it automatically puts the weight into the health app. Now, in addition to that, we can also add our own data. So let's say it missed a date. I went and weighed myself on a scale that doesn't talk to the health app. I'd like to add that data. How can I do that? You're going to see add data. I tap on this and I can go and add my weight in there. So in some of these categories, not only does it read the information from a device such as a scale or the Apple Watch, but in some cases you're able to go and add your own data. A perfect example of that is nutrition. If you want to keep track of your nutrition, what you can do is tap on a category and you can go and add your own data there. Or what you could do is you could swipe up here and then you can find an app that'll help you with adding that nutrition information in there. So that's how we can browse our different categories and see all of our different data. Now let's take a closer look at the summary here. When I tap on summary, I get basically a lot of the same information, but it's all customized for me. You're going to see that I have my pinned categories. So when I pin a category, what it's going to do is it's going to show up in this area here. And then when I tap on any one of them, let's just go with steps here. I tap on that and I can view that category. From here I can swipe up, view highlights. I can also see my steps. I can read about it. I can see which apps will help me track my steps. I can unpin it from my summary. I can even go and add data to this one. So basically what you'll want to do is you'll want to go over to browse, take a look at the categories, the ones that you want to keep track of or have easy access to. You go and pin it, and then what it'll do is it'll show up in the summary, and then you have easy access to it. Also under summary, we are going to have different trends. I swipe up and you're going to see I can see all of my different trends. I can also see my highlights here. And when I swipe up, in addition to that, I can read different articles, and then I can see also what apps may help me track my health. So that's how summary works. Basically, it just gives us quick access to various categories here. Now, if you want to share your data with someone, then what you do is you go over here to share. When I tap on share, what I'm able to do is see the data from people that are sharing their data with me. So my wife, Beth, is sharing her health app with me. So I can tap on this and then view any information about her. So when I tap on it, you're going to see that she has one alert. And that is, she was in a loud environment. To go back, you just tap on sharing. and it brings you back. If you want to ask someone to share their data, you can tap on Ask Someone to Share. And when you swipe up, we also have the same button here, Ask Someone to Share. In addition to that, you want to share your data with someone, you tap on that, and it'll share your data with someone. And then last, if you want to share it with your doctor, if they allow this, you're also able to share your data with the doctor. All of this is secure, so you don't have to worry about anyone just getting this information. It is all encrypted and secure. So that's basically how the health app works and how you can use it to monitor your health. There are a lot of different categories that are available, and there are a lot of different devices and apps that are available that can help you monitor your health. So what I would recommend doing is going over to browse and taking a look at some of the categories that you want to keep track of. And then when you do that, when you tap on a category and tap on the subcategory, you're able to see which apps are able to help you monitor that. You can pin it to your summary, and then you'll have easy access to it from your summary. And then if you want to share your data or view shared data, you can go under the sharing tab, and then you can ask someone to share their data, or what you're able to do is share your data with someone else. So that is how the health app works on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video, you can subscribe to my channel, you can share it with your friends and family. In addition to that, what you may want to do is check out danstutorials.com. Not only do I have more videos there, but I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, what I'll do for you is I'll take out all of the ads from the videos. You'll have access to that AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius. And you'll have access to my classes and webinars that I hold on a regular basis. You're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.